Welcome to Overcoming Testimonies, brought to you by Eden Mesganaw of Remax Premier and ObeyEthiopianDishes.com, where God's greatness is your testimony. Now, here's your hosts, Pastor Yonatan and Eden Mesganaw.
Shalom to you all, WDCX family. This is Pastor Yonatan with my co-host, Eden Mesganaw. This is Overcoming Testimonies, coming to you every Saturday at this time. Thank you for sharing your part of your weekend. Thank you very much. We do have today Pastor Peter Ruperelia. Did I pronounce Perfect. Your name correctly?
Perfect.
Okay, so we had him last Saturday as well, and he was telling us an awesome testimony, personal testimony, and what the Lord is doing around the ministry that he's involved in. And I'd like to invite you to join me in prayer, committing this time to the Lord. Let's pray together. Heavenly Father, we thank you. We thank you. We bless your precious name. And I ask you, Father God, for your presence to increase in our midst and wherever our listeners are. And Lord, we thank you again in Jesus' name. Amen. And over to you. Would you read us the scripture and then give us a little recap of what Pastor Peter was telling us last Saturday?
Okay, so I'll do our team verse, which is Revelation chapter 12, verses 11. And it says, "They overcame him by the blood of the Lamb, by the word of their testimony, and they were never afraid to die for
Amen.
Their faith."
Amen.
So, and that's a kind of powerful testimony that Peter Ruperelia shared with us last week. Just to do a little recap, he came from a background, Hindu family background. The family left him, or just disowned. Pretty much disowned. Disown you because you chose, you fall in love with this girl that they did not arrange to get married to. Mm-hmm. So, and then you got married to her, you fall in love with her, you're living with her, but all of a sudden you saw her in a terrible affair in your own car. So at that time, and of course you're heavily involved with her and her family with drugs, alcohol. Yeah. And when you found that out, you pretty much got rid of her. You tell her to take every property that you guys mm-hmm. own, even though you're broke, because you pretty much were mm-hmm. using all the money yeah. you have to really waste yourself. Is
yeah.
that what
yeah.
So now you came back to your apartment literally to kill yourself.
Yes.
And how you decided to do was with, you know, drugs, all the drugs you have, all the rum, like the 100% rum, like
yes,
bottle,
yes.
you did that. But as you're trying to kill yourself, Jesus met you. He met you, he hugged you, he poured his love over you.
Yes.
And at the same time, you happened to have that divine call with people that were led with the Holy Spirit
yes.
to lead you to Christ. So that was your backstory. And then again, God gave you the vision of founding and leading Voices of the Nation.
Yes.
So here you are in the city of Toronto, leading the concert, the multicultural concert for Jesus. The only denominator or the common thing in this is anybody that loves Jesus, mm. who's saved by Jesus, is welcome to participate. And you have once a year.
Yes.
And I believe this year is going to be August the 3rd.
August the 3rd, Caravana
yeah.
weekend, yes.
That's right. Mm. Yeah. So tell us the preparation, or, you know, like what it is like in terms of the kind of help you need, support you need. Yeah, just tell us what you would, or if you want to give us a little recap of this year movement of what's happening with the Voice of the Nations.
Every year, we have it on the around the same weekend, mm-hmm. the Caravana weekend. God has opened that door. It's been, this will be our ninth year this year.
Mm-hmm. Praise the Lord.
We were the first Christian organization to get, we're able to do an all-day gospel concert at Young and Dundas Square.
Mm-hmm.
God opened that door in 2011 for us. After other organizations came after, because and everybody knows that we had a battle with the city. They wanted to close us down because they said that we were proselytizing.
Mm-hmm.
But, you know, we overcame that. God helped us overcome that. And this year's event is going to be on the Caravana weekend again. Basically, what we have is we We invite churches, worship teams to participate, to come and be part of the event. I will, normally we look at, we ask them to go on our website and submit their worship teams, or even if there's an artist that are interested in participating. And the object is to come together, to bring together the denominations and the cultures, you know, and come in and bring heaven's rehearsal on earth.
Heaven's rehearsal. Tell us about the website address so that people could...
It's voicesofthenations.com.
That's it. Voices of the Nations. Is there S at the...
After plural. The voices and S com. After the nations.
So is the schedule filled for that rehearsal or there's still opening?
We're still looking for worship teams. If you are interested in being part of it, you can go on our website.
Mm-hmm.
And put in a submission.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, the way we, because this is an outreach for the city, so we normally don't have honorariums for the artists and the worship teams.
Right.
They just donate their time because they have the heart for outreach for the city. So we don't normally pay the artists because the cost itself for Dundas Square is so much, right?
Right.
So
right.
We, every penny that we raise goes towards the cost of the venue.
And we have the responsibility to go out there and gospel.
Exactly.
The least we could do is
absolutely
give our time and enjoy it for us because we're, you know, we're just doing God's work.
Yes.
So that's, and just, you know, I went back to think your Hindu background. I don't know much about that. Any results with your family? Anybody, like, did you guys got back after they disowned you? Like, how did that work?
Yeah, no, God restored the relationship. It was only about 5 years that we were separate, but they saw the change in my life.
Mm-hmm.
For positive.
So they saw the difference in my life.
Mm-hmm.
So my mom was the first one that accepted me, right? And from that, none of my family is saved.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
right?
You're not Christians. Yeah.
Only me and my... I have a testimony that how I met my wife.
Right.
I was always attracted to white women.
Uh-huh.
I was never attracted to Indian women. Right? And I had the perfect wife that I had on written down that what I wanted. And I was praying to God for two years. I said, you know, and nothing was happening.
Mm-hmm.
So one day I'm going... and taking one of my pastors to a conference, and he tells me, why don't you repent and ask God for who he has for me than who I want, right? So right there, I repented and I asked God to forgive me, right? And I said, whoever you have. 2 weeks later, I met my wife on a blind date.
Okay.
And it's funny how God works, right? It turns out that she's Indian.
Mm-hmm.
She's from a Brahmin background, which is in the Hindu caste system.
Yeah.
Normally, she's a priesthood, right? So we're the business people, so we can't even allow to go to their house and nothing.
Oh, okay.
So God brought me, so she came into my life. It's funny, when we started talking, it turns out that my brother, who sponsored me to come here, and Bina's parents, her name is Bina, her parents go to the same Indian functions together.
Oh, okay.
And I don't know if you remember last Saturday when I spoke about how my sister was the one that helped.
Yes.
Yeah,
you know,
stayed with
her.
Yes.
It turns out that Bina's dad
and
my sister's husband, they're the ones who helped me remember.
Okay.
Right.
They used to go to the same, they used to play as kids together.
Oh,
in Africa, where we were from.
That's
right?
Amazing.
That's, and then we speak the same language, we know the same food.
Mm-hmm.
And when I, everything I lost when I met Bina, God replaced.
Amen.
The cars we had,
you
know, when I met her, we had brand new cars. You know, I moved in with her family, and they took me in like their
Your
own
family.
So the family that I lost was replaced.
Wow.
It's like God replaced everything.
Yes.
Are Bina's parents Christians?
No, in both sides we're the only ones that are
but
we're believing as Pastor
Reverend Greg
said
Morrison,
about
yes
how, you know, we believing that scripture that all my family is going to be saved. Mm. And it's coming.
Amen.
Because they see our walk. And
right.
they see,
right, right.
Like, we, for example, Bina's parents, when they call us and they ask for prayer,
mm-hmm.
they say, oh, your God always answers prayers, so pray for us.
Wow.
Your God always answers prayers.
Mm. Is that what they say?
That's what she said. So I know God is open.
Yes,
and they'll come. So.
Yeah. Well, you're anointed, so that is wonderful.
Praise
again, this year program for Voices of the Nation is on August the 3rd.
Yes.
Anyone that wants to volunteer or help could go to your website.
Yes.
Or do you have a phone number to give it to them for you?
It's on the website.
On the website as well.
My phone number is on the website.
416-876-3877.
And they can call me, you know, and they can put in a submission. There's a volunteer submission form. There's a sponsorship. If you are a business person and they want to have a booth,
mm-hmm.
we have sponsorship packages available. And, you know, you'll be a blessing to us.
Wonderful. The number again is 416-876-3877. Now it's our break, and stay with us. Okay, welcome back again. And Pastor Peter, we were talking a little bit about some resources that the Voices of the Nations got to, you know, work with church and stuff. So what would you like to say to church leaders in terms of evangelism? You know, just going out of the four corners of the church building in, you know, reaching out our city, the city of Toronto or GTA in general.
Yes. See, one of the things that's lacking in our city is that churches, instead of working together for evangelism, I find pastors and churches, they're more interested in their own, you know, congregation or their own, you know, churches growing.
Right.
But it's more than that. It's the church is only four walls. We are the church.
Right.
So what our pastors need to realize that it's not about the four walls. It's about us out there.
Kingdom, yes.
Like I'm a pastor, but to me, I'm not a pastor in a church.
Mm.
I'm a pastor of the people out there.
Yes.
That's my congregation is everyone that's lost out there.
Right.
That's my congregation.
Mm.
That's where I'm supposed to be.
Mm.
Thank you, Jesus. That's really great. So tell us about that truck. The truck.
Yes.
Yeah.
We have an outreach resource that we use.
Mm-hmm.
It's a truck that turns into a stage.
Mm.
It comes with two barbecues, 100 chairs, and a sound system.
Mm-hmm.
So what we do, and it's got a built-in generator, so we don't need electrical power.
Right.
We can park the truck anywhere.
Mm-hmm.
And we can do a community barbecue,
mm-hmm.
where we can invite the community to come out,
mm-hmm.
and just have a free barbecue, meet your neighbor barbecues, and that can just, and then we can tell them about Christ.
Yes.
And, you know, it's a great tool that we love to use to evangelize in the city.
Mm.
So if a church was interested, they could give you a call and...
Yes, they can call us, me.
And what do you call it? They rent that truck
they
service.
They can
borrow
that. They can rent it. Uh-huh. And obviously the cost is towards the gas, because it runs in diesel and stuff.
Yes.
So yeah, you know,
there's
a cost behind it.
Yeah.
But they can call, and I can tell them exactly what the cost is.
So now, I have a question with that, like in terms of the city or, you know, even provinces. Do you need a permit?
Yes, you do.
If somebody was going to do that, you need a permit.
A lot of times, if it's your church parking lot,
mm-hmm.
you don't need a permit
church
or nothing.
Church parking lot,
because, you know, a lot of churches have a big, huge parking lot. So you just set it up there and just invite the people in the neighborhood to come out.
Mm-hmm.
But sometimes if you're going to have in the parks, then you need a permit.
Okay, special permit from
the
city.
So you need a permit.
Yeah.
And, you know, before I forget, I just want to mention, you know, with Voices of the Nations, I want to just thank the Ford family. Because if it wasn't for Rob, Doug, and even Michael Ford, because of them giving us endorsements, that's why Dundas Square normally waives the permit fee.
Oh, Okay.
Normally it's like close to $4,000 for permit.
Okay.
So I just wanted to mention that is that, you know, I love the whole family. Mm-hmm. You know, I know them, and I just want to thank them. Mm.
They waived the $4,000 permit fee that.
Yeah,
you,
because there's an endorsement
from the
counselor.
Thank you, city councilor.
So yeah, but you do need a permit.
Yeah.
To have an event in the park, and we build the relationship now. Mm-hmm. Ever since that happened, we have a good relationship with Dundas Square now. You know, we've been working together.
Yeah.
And it's also when we go out to get other permits, mm-hmm. it helps us because, you know, we've got the permit from Dundas Square, so it helps us so we can do evangelism in other mm-hmm. areas too. Mm-hmm.
Excellent.
So now let's say there are some leaders, you know, church leaders are listening to our conversation now, and they don't have any experience of going out, you know, in outreach. So is there any help that you guys can, the voices of the nations can provide in how to do an outreach, for example?
With me, I'd be more than happy, if they're interested, I'd be more than happy to consult with them mm. and tell them how it's done and what to do and how to get the permits. I can do that for them. Okay. That's my heart is for the people out there. Yeah. So if you're doing evangelism, I'll go out of my way to help you.
Praise the Lord.
So if you are interested in doing an outreach in our city, in GTA, the number to contact Pastor Peter or the Voices of the Nations is 416-876-3877. The number again is 416-876-3877.
Well, Peter, thank you so much for
being with us.
Continue to shine the light. I bet our God is very happy with you, and he's going to continue to bless you. We may do this again, but again, to the audience, I want to let you know this program, this Voice of the Nation event is happening on Dundas Square on August the 3rd, 2019.
Can I just add something? Uh-huh. We are a nonprofit organization, we are accepting donations through the website.
Mm-hmm. That's right.
And you'll be more than happy to give you a tax receipt.
Mm-hmm.
And every cent goes to the event itself. It doesn't go. I don't get a salary. I have a full time job.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
It's just something that God has given me to do for Him,
mm-hmm.
and
mm-hmm.
I'm just fulfilling His mandate for my life.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah.
Anything you can support to do to help us will be appreciated. Mm.
We do really encourage every one of you to support this ministry, which is absolutely vital for our city. VoicesOfTheNations.com, www.voicesofthenations.com, and you can support this ministry. Pastor Peter, thank you so much for coming out and have this wonderful and awesome conversation. Thank you so much.
Love Ethiopian food? Then you're going to love a buyethiopiandishes.com, an online grocery store for all Ethiopian, Aterian, and African food lovers. This online grocery store is filled with all the Ethiopian foods you love at affordable prices. Items are available in vegan and dairy-free. Kulet, wet, and injera come in spicy and non-spicy and can be delivered to your home in Toronto. Now you can cook or warm and eat your Ethiopian meal every day of the week in the comfort of your own home. Purchase your products online at buyethiopiandishes.com or stock up on your favorite items at a store near you. Just click on the link on the website that says retail locations and you'll find dozens of stores that carry Kulet, Wet, and Injera. And if you want to pass on your love of Ethiopian food to family and friends, Abai also sells gift baskets, perfect for any gift-giving occasion. For more information, call 416-918-5979. That's 416-918-5979.
Eat in Mesganaw Remax Premier has a church congregation in need of a new building. The number of members is increasing and they are looking to acquire a bigger church. If you have property in Scarborough you want to sell, call Eden at 416-918-5979. If you have land you want to sell, call Eden. If you have a vacant building big enough for a great congregation, call Eden. If you know of a church or worship place, call Eden at 416-918-5979. Zoning is key. If you already have a church but need less space, Eden can talk to you about an exchange and get what your church is worth. Whether you are buying or selling your home, need property for a church or any other commercial real estate need, or just want some good advice, call Eden Mesganaw of RE/MAX Premier. Make your appointment today by calling 416-918-5979. When you do, don't forget to mention you heard her ad on WDCX. Check out her website at Eden4realestate.com.
This is Overcoming Testimonies, sponsored by Abai Ethiopian Dishes and Eden Mesganaw, RE/MAX Real Estate. We have heard Pastor Peter's interview, and I hope that we are very much inspired by it. The gospel of Jesus Christ is the power of God. The importance of preaching is clearly stated in the Bible, and the church does not seem to consider it. I'm not saying the church does not know about it, but knowing and doing are two separate things. The first church in history was too content and living in her comfort zone, but until persecution broke out. When Stephen was killed and the church was persecuted, the word of Jesus first got fulfilled. As the church scattered everywhere and the believers started preaching the gospel, and the kingdom of God was spreading everywhere in the known world then. We live on this side of the world, in North America, on the East Coast, in Canada or in the US these days. And we need to ask ourselves, do we need to wait until persecution breaks out so that we go out of our comfort zone to preach the gospel? Or do we need to stop all meaningless things that are making us so busy and hindering us preaching the gospel? The first and foremost responsibility of the church is preaching the gospel. Why? Because it's the Lord's command. The church first responsibility is not organizing the choir. It's not feeding the poor. It is not to run discipleship classes and so on. And I'm not saying that all these things that I have mentioned, I've just been mentioning, are not necessary. But first thing first, the gospel comes first. When we preach the gospel, all of the above things I mentioned will follow as a result, and they come into existence as a fruit of the gospel. When we preach the gospel, there are many, many lost souls all around us, in our neighborhood, on the street, or in our workplaces, and so on. We should tell them the good news, and the Lord will be with us till the end of the age, because He promised us. Our responsibility is to share the good news and not to transform the person. Transforming the person is up to the Holy Spirit and God. So we just need to trust God and share the gospel. As the Bible says, how beautiful on the mountains are the feet of those who bring good news, who proclaim peace, who bring good tidings, who proclaim salvation, who says to Zion, your God reigns. Isaiah chapter 52 verse 7. It takes a huge initiative, big step, lots of hard work and sweating to climb up over the mountain. If preaching the gospel was just going over to the field, it would have been very, very easy. But the Bible says, those who go over the mountaintop was good news. Getting out and step forward to get out of your comfort zone and preach the gospel. It may cost you a lot, but that's the only way going out and see souls
being transformed by the Spirit of God. Your reward in heaven will be great, and it glorifies the Lord. May the Lord help each and every one of us follow his commands. Jesus said, "Go ye therefore and teach all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Ghost, teaching them to observe all things whatsoever I have commanded you. And lo, I am with you always, even unto the end of the world." Amen. That's Matthew chapter 28. I really want to pray for those of you who are really inspired by the interview that we've done with Pastor Peter and by the things that I've just been mentioning. And I'd like to pray with you and for you right now. In the name of Jesus Christ, Lord, I pray for each and every one of our listeners, Father God, and especially, Father God, for those whom your Spirit has been speaking and inspiring, Father God, and challenging to get out of their comfort zone. Holy Spirit, in the name of Jesus Christ, I pray, give everyone, Father God, the right boldness, Father God, to go out and preach the gospel, which is the power of God, as your word says. I pray in the name of Jesus Christ, I pray that you give each and everyone a fruit, Father God, as they preach the gospel, so that souls will be changed and transformed in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. May the Lord bless you and keep you. And I hope to see you next week. God bless you. Goodbye.
Thanks for joining us on Overcoming Testimonies. Make sure to tune in next Saturday at 8 p.m. for more encouraging testimonies right here on WDCX.
Do you love Ethiopian food? Then you're going to love abuyethiopiandishes.com, an online grocery store for all Ethiopian, Aterian, and African food lovers. This online grocery store is filled with all the Ethiopian foods you love at affordable prices. Items are available in vegan and dairy-free. Kulet, wet, and injera come in spicy and non-spicy and can be delivered to your home in Toronto. Now you can cook or warm and eat your Ethiopian meal every day of the week in the comfort of your own home. Purchase your products online at abuyethiopiandishes.com or stock up on your favorite items at a store near you. Just click on the link on the website that says retail locations and you'll find dozens of stores that carry kulet, wet, and injera. And if you want to pass on your love of Ethiopian food to family and friends, Abuy also sells gift baskets, perfect for any gift-giving occasion. For more information, call 416-918-5979. That's 416-918-5979.
Eden Mesganaw Remax Premier has a church congregation in need of a new building. The number of members is increasing and they are looking to acquire a bigger church. If you have property in Scarborough you want to sell, call Eden at 416-918-5979. If you have land you want to sell, call Eden. If you have a vacant building big enough for a great congregation, call Eden. If you know of a church or worship place, call Eden at 416-918-5979. Zoning is key. If you already have a church but need less space, Eden can talk to you about an exchange and get what your church is worth. Whether you are buying or selling your home, need property for a church or any other commercial real estate need, or just want some good advice, call Eden Mesganaw of RE/MAX Premier. Make your appointment today by calling 416-918-5979. When you do, don't forget to mention you heard her ad on WDCX. Check out her website at Eden4realestate.com.
Items are available in vegan and dairy-free. Kulet, wet, and injera come in spicy and non-spicy and can be delivered to your home in Toronto. Now you can cook or warm and eat your Ethiopian meal every day of the week in the comfort of your own home. Purchase your products online at abuyethiopiandishes.com or stock up on your favorite items at a store near you. Just click on the link on the website that says retail locations and you'll find dozens of stores that carry kulet, wet, and injera. And if you want to pass on your love of Ethiopian food to family and friends, Abuy also sells gift baskets, perfect for any gift-giving occasion. For more information, call 416-918-5979. That's 416-918-5979.